Hey there, it's Alina, your friendly nuclear physicist, and today we're going to be making a reaction video reacting to some TikTok videos that are related to nuclear physics, seeing what's accurate and what's not, and generally having some fun together. So let's get into it. Okay. This is actually true. Atoms are in the center, comprised of their nucleus. And around it, there is basically a lot of electrons that are traveling in orbits. And it does look like a cloud of electrons because they are, you know, a lot of electrons traveling. So you can kind of think of it as a cloud. But I still do believe that the picture that we usually show to represent an atom, it is quite representative, but you have to imagine that there is much more electrons than what you actually see, because if there were so many in the picture, it would look very crowded and it will look confusing. I understand this video, but I still think that the picture actually does the job, at least from like educational perspective. I like how it says, so you're mostly empty space. That is actually true. The electrons are quite far away from the nucleus. Nucleus is positively charged and the electrons are negatively charged. And this is the kind of atom construction that we see in the pictures is kind of shrinked so we can see it and it's more representative and we understand what's happening. But in reality, yes, the nucleus is central and the electrons are quite far away. So in between, it is indeed empty space.
All right, guys, today I'm gonna teach you how to survive a nuclear bomb.
A nuclear bomb. So I'm very interested about this video because we have made our first YouTube video about this topic. So I'm interested if she's going to say similar things to what we already discussed.
Just in case. Boom, the bomb went off, you have to act fast, okay? First things first, don't look at the flash, it'll blind you, and try not to look at other people either because the flash can act like an x-ray and you'll be definitely seeing some skeletons. If you can't...
That's true, we already mentioned that do not get basically intrigued by looking at the blast because you can damage your eyes.
My eyes!
So far so good.
And Shelty, your best bet is going to be to lay down on the ground, face down, covering your head and ears. I would probably still do this even if I had shelter. And like I said, there's gonna be x-rays, but also gamma rays and thermal rays, which are not going to feel good. They're going to be actively burning you.
So all kinds of radiation will be emitted from the explosion. So you would want to get shelter as quickly as possible. As she's also mentioning, if you don't have a shelter, then you should lie on the ground, preferably face down and covering your head and your ears from the sound of the blast and also from the radiation that is going to come along, and you don't want your face to get burned, or try basically to get as much less contamination as you can.
Doesn't matter, you have to get up, fight through the pain, and just find shelter. Don't get into a car, that's like the worst idea you could have. A bomb shelter is ideal, but any brick or concrete building is going to be helpful. Even if you could just find a cave, get inside of it, because the poisonous rain is coming and it will kill everything in its path.
Yeah, when she says poisonous rain, I'm assuming she means the radioactive fallout. So the particles that are evaporated then eventually will cool down and drop on the ground. I wasn't sure what she meant about it's a worse idea getting into a car. I mean, the car will not protect you from the radiation, so I guess that is why, but it wasn't really explanatory.
Also probably take off your clothes because they are just covered in radiation. And if you somehow...
Exactly, as we mentioned, if you were outside at the time of the blast, you do need to remove your clothing and either dispose it, or preferably dispose it, don't even try to wash it, and take a very good shower.
Oh, made it this far? You're doing better than most, so like for a part two. All right, guys, today I'm gonna...
Imagine wanting to survive. Why wouldn't you want to survive? I can take a burn from the curling iron, nonetheless a nuclear bomb. Yeah, that would be on a totally different scale.
Action.
Stick bomb. Chain reaction.
Follow to see a tutorial.
Okay, so it's showing kind of with the sticks how a chain nuclear reaction works. I like it for school purposes, I would say. In a sense that once the one stick is activated, once you hit the first stick, all of the sticks go after that and you can't really stop them. It is, of course, it is accurate, but it is nevertheless simplistic in a sense that in a chain reaction, from the moment you start and with the atoms you start the reaction, you don't really continue with the same amount of atoms. So the more the reaction progresses, the more atoms are fissioning and the more neutrons are producing. So basically, I would say, if you were to represent it more realistically, you would start from here and you would go like expanding. But nevertheless, yeah, interesting video to understand the idea. Okay, so there are all three types of radiation here. Are they going to try and run and see what they can pass through? I guess this requires some basic, let's say, nuclear physics understanding. There's three types of radiation, alpha, beta and gamma, like this men have their stickers on the back. And alpha is the one that it is very harmful, but it is actually heavier atom, so it doesn't travel that far, so it can be stopped by a thin piece of paper or a piece of clothing. And then beta is charged particles like electrons, and it can travel through paper, it can travel through clothing, but it will also stop eventually, for example, on your skin. It can only create like a rash on the surface of the skin, but not actually penetrate. And then gamma is photons, and photons are actually traveling all the way through materials. They are rarely stopped, except if the material or the construction is actually designed to prevent the gamma radiation. And the best way to prevent that is to have thick concrete walls, and that's why you see, for example, in nuclear constructions or in safety kind of barriers, there is thick nuclear there's thick cement walls to protect the gamma radiation to escape. But I'm interested to see what they're gonna do in the video. Okay, alpha goes slower. Alpha is done. Okay, so alpha goes slower, and then he was done before even reaching the paper. Beta passed the paper. Beta met the aluminum and he's like, no, not going there. Gamma is keeping going. Exactly, and when gamma met the concrete wall, then he was just bounced back and that was it. That was actually very funny. I really liked this video and very educational and very kind of easy to understand, because sometimes when you read it in the books, you can't really visualize what is the difference, like what does it do, what's the effect. So it's pretty understandable and in a funny way. I like that. Yeah, that actually is the case, but I'm not sure how the video tries to portray it, if the radioactive explosion helped with the basically nature reviving, or if it's just the lack of the humans there. Because the thing is that because the Chernobyl has an exclusion zone, so no people are allowed to enter or leave in the areas that is approximately 30 kilometers outside of the nuclear power plant that the reactor exploded at. So in these areas, of course, no human activity has happened in a while, and no constructions, nobody was destroying trees or anything like that. So of course the nature has flourished, but that is not to say that the radioactive fallout helped the nature to flourish. So this is not the same. It is because humans were not there, so nothing was destroyed basically, so nature was by itself rebuilding itself. Yeah, it's very interesting to see these rooms and structures now. You can actually visit Chernobyl as a tourist for a controlled amount of time, and only in the areas that the radiation is quite low. Yeah, so what is happening here is a nuclear reactor starting up for the first time, and how that happens is that there's a neutron source that emits neutrons to initiate the chain fission reaction. And what you see, why it shines blue, is called Cherenkov radiation, and this is charged particles, usually electrons, traveling in the water, because the whole core is in the water, traveling through the water faster than the speed of light in that medium. So what it's usually people say, they stop at the sentence that the electrons travel in the water faster than the speed of light, period. And this is inaccurate and sort of a misinformation, because people don't really understand what that means, because the speed of light is the fastest speed anyone can ever reach, and that is in vacuum. However, the speed of light in other mediums such as water, oil or any other kind of material that you can travel through is smaller, is smaller than the speed of light in vacuum. And that is why it's said here that electrons travel faster in water than the light travels in water. So that is why you see the emission of the blue light. In my opinion, one of the most fascinating moments as a nuclear physicist, and I've actually had the chance to experience that in real life. We were on a training during my studies in a training facility, and we actually saw the Cherenkov radiation created, and we also took some pictures. It was a really, really once in a lifetime experience. I would have just run away. Yeah, this is the kind of comments I was expecting. Because you don't have to run away. There is nothing that is going to happen to you. Everything is contained within the water. Props to the cameraman for risking their life for this footage. Yeah, same with the previous comment. Nobody risked their life to take this picture. And most probably these pictures are taken by a camera that is stationary and looking at the reactor core in itself. So you don't really have to stand on it and record. Okay, thanks for watching, and I will definitely make a part two. There is some more interesting ones I would like to check out with you guys. I've been Elina, your friendly nuclear physicist. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Leave a comment down below. Tell me what you think about this video, as well as what other videos you would like me to react to in the future. Up until next time, see you soon. What?